I had a problem to solve, and I wanted to solve it quick, which was the reason for this project.
How many problems do you have?
99.
All the ones. That's
actually.
Hey! Hey! How are you doing? I'm MJ. I'm in my fourth year of software engineering.
Cool, so I heard you have a project to show for us today.
Yeah, so it's a vocabulary list builder that you can find words in Japanese to and add them to your vocab list.
Oh, nice. How are you feeling about it?
Yeah, it's good to go. I've polished it up, ready for this presentation, so yeah.
Nice. Can you give us a brief overview of the project?
Yeah, so basically when you put in a word, you can click a button to add it to your word list. And when you're done with all the words, you can export it as a text file. So it can be imported into your vocab software. So basically with my app, first you enter any word or phrase in Romaji or in English or the kanji if you really would like. Let's say table, because I'm using a table right now. All the results come up. They are labeled with their tags, if there are common word and which level of the JLPT they are associated with. This button allows you to add it to your list, so let's add table to the list. And you can view the current word list with the table here. And finally, you can export it as a text file. So here's the export, zoom in. And then here you can remove it from the list. Cool. And let's try another word. Let's try transition.
Cut.
Sag. So I study Japanese in my spare time. As you do when reading a novel in a foreign language, you come across words that you don't know. I was just finding it really annoying having to put my book down, put the bookmark back in, type up, copy and paste, and open back the book. And like, where was I reading? Oh, here. And also I took some inspiration from other people's personal projects which they have posted online to their GitHubs. The first thing I would probably suggest is try and find something about your life that could be simplified somehow. Especially with the industry that we're in, software. Like, you could solve any problem that you want. If you can't think of something like that, a good start is always a personal website. You can chuck your biography on it, your LinkedIn, your resume. If you don't want to do that either, then you could always join hackathons where they tell you exactly what to make, so it sort of saves you from coming up with an idea yourself. First, I had to find the API for the dictionary. Thankfully, there was one that was maintained by the dictionary themselves. Next, I wrote the front end for it. I had to implement a back end to go with front end. But the biggest motivation was that I had a problem that I needed to solve, which was looking up words is too tedious. So in order to save me from the tedium, I wanted to make this. It was more like a spare time sort of thing. So in the time where I could have watched an episode, I just did some work on the project. Yeah, so this was, I think, the third project that I attempted. My first one was a card game, and my second one was my personal website. So I sort of knew kind of what React was, and I figured that'd be enough, and it was. I hadn't done 6080 at this point, so I didn't have any formal experience in getting taught how to make front ends. The back end part was quite new to me, so I just spent a bit more time working on that. I guess a big thing was just making it look good. I mean, if your website's ugly, no one's gonna use it.
How aesthetic would you say your website is?
I would say it's usable. It looks fine.
Hey James, how good do you think MJ's website looks?
It's mid.
The colors differentiate the buttons and there's enough contrast.
It's really good. Like, it's extremely good.
I think the best thing is just to get started.
Wait, did he just say started? Yes, you can get started on a project for the annual personal projects competition. Check out our Facebook page for more info. Okay, back to MJ.
With the internet, you can just Google anything and there's no shortage of resources. You can't be stuck because there are so many things out there that will help you. So yeah, just get your hands dirty and get coding. And that's the fastest way you'll learn. Because everyone and their mother wants a website now. And the only way, am I allowed to say that?
Yeah.
I am the team lead for notangles. Random notangles shield, please use notangles to plan your timetable. It'll be updated every term with the latest classes. So,
how much do you love notangles?
I love notangles.
Show us some love.